It's actually a welcome news for publicly traded casinos companies, particularly the ones that are exposed to the states where it's legalized, like New Jersey. We don't really think it's going to be a huge revenue driver for the casinos themselves. A lot of the sports book action has been outsourced actually to the UK sports books, some of the daily fantasy sports companies out there. But
so guys sit home on their couch. They don't go to the casino.
A lot of times they
don't.
That
doesn't sound like good news.
Especially in New Jersey, where mobile betting is legal.
Because don't you want to get them in the casino so they order drinks and then another six drinks and then some food and they throw some money down on the blackjack table?
That's right. In some states like Mississippi, where sports betting is legal, but confined to the four walls of the casino, you are seeing an impact of year-over-year robust growth since sports betting has been introduced in sports betting and in other segments of the casino like slots and tables.
Any day you can learn something, I think, is a good day, right? And I learned something from your excellent notes today, which is that the slot machine is sort of the cash cow for casino. I had no idea.
80% of the revenues.
It's incredible, 80%. And young people, they don't like slot machines.
No, to our best knowledge.
So that doesn't sound good for a lot of these companies.
That's right. So we do view regional gaming, which is everything outside of Las Vegas, as secularly weak. That's not to say it's falling off the cliff. It's still one of the, relative to retail, some other segments, it's still, you know, pretty healthy, but secularly weak because people are retiring, and those are the people that are playing slot machines, and their discretionary income is declining. So you're trying to rely on the millennials to come in and backfill, but the millennials are not coming to the casino.
The biggest change in gambling in probably 20 years has just happened, and nobody else but you, I think, and maybe us right now are talking about it, and that is Japan. It's been illegal to gamble in Japan forever. They got these weird pachinko parlors. Now it is going to be legal to gamble. Japan is a lot wealthier nation than China is per capita. Is this going to make a difference for U.S. operators? Or Wynn or Las Vegas, are they going to go into Japan in a big way?
Yeah, if anybody could get an Osaka license or a Tokyo license, that would be a very big deal. That would be the biggest thing since Singapore or Macau 10, 15 years ago. But we're sort of tempering people's expectations because there are quite a bit of regulation in place in Japan. People have to pay an entrance fee to gamble. There's a very high tax rate, which will impact how much you could market. The casino floors will be somewhat confined to a limited space. So we're coming out with about a $6 to $9 billion forecast for the whole market, which is relatively small relative to a $70 billion market in the U.S. And a lot of that has to do with just the regulation.